dear colleagues, dear friends, I'm happy to be to the first Far Eastern Forum, and I hope it becomes really important for developing our economy, for developing the Far Eastern regions. I believe that development of the travel sector is especially important for developing the regions of Far East. And I would like to support this statement by the facts that last year the travel industry of the Russian Federation grew by 30%, and we see the same trend this year. There is a growth of tourism, and sadly we cannot. So some experts estimate that they are about 30%. So Vladimir Ivanovich and Vladimir Vladimirovich mentioned that the domestic travel is growing. The foreign travel also grows, and in the first quarter of this year, the Russian Statistics Agency reported the growth of 16%. Because, as it has been said, the growth of tourists from Asia Pacific regions was twofold, and we believe that tourism could become a driver of our economy, because it starts to work when tourism brings cash money into the economy of the country. And this is like an export of our services, not related to raw materials. Many voices say that tourism, that economy of Russia is largely linked to exports of mineral resources. Also, tourism is an element of soft power and developing ideology. Tourism quickly produces labor in rural areas or in clusters focused on one industry. In areas where it's not profitable to build industrial enterprises, but due to tourism, those areas see potential for development. And importantly, tourism develops infrastructure. And when we talk about developing special infrastructure for tourism and the development of Vladivostok as a city, you see that infrastructure serves to the residents of the city who use the motorways and see the nice buildings built before the APEC summit. So the level of comfort grows, and that contributes to better social stability and happier life of our residents, which is very important component, because we know that human needs not only bread, but also show feelings, impressions, memories are quite important. What's the driver for the economy? The driver are digital technologies, and digital technologies are number one for companies which are on the market. So 80% of the content in social media is tourism. So the Far East, as the region, the entire region, has huge potential for developing tourism. And the share which currently the Far East accounts for in domestic and foreign tourism, so it could be further increased, and to me it's possible to do it very quickly. And what's important, the government and the president of the Russian Federation and heads of the government, they pay attention to developing tourism, and this is an important sign for investors. And I believe that currently we are telling investors, dear colleagues, developing tourism in the Far East is a strategic priority. And you should probably focus on whether you can invest in the travel industry, because that would give rise to tourist flows, and all necessary measures will be taken. And also, I fully agree with my colleagues. There are three main areas for developing tourism, developing infrastructure in the broader sense of the word, then the quality of the tourist program, and thirdly, this is promoting the tourist product inside the country and abroad. So if we would talk from those three perspectives, it's important to admit that the travel, the tourist infrastructure of the Far East is underdeveloped, and developing the cruise ship infrastructure is really critical, and we understand that our harbors are not so deep and will lack pierces, and there is a complicated system of permits, there is a shortage of checkpoints, those were items raised and they have to be sorted out. Also, there is a trend in the world for simplifying visa admission regime, and also there are more advanced technologies like electronic visas and multiple visas. Visas could be obtained on arrival to the airport. And our country, of course, needs to be competitive. And I fully agree with the statement of by Vladimir Vladimirovich. The Far East has unique geographical position. It's close to the Asia-Pacific region, which is a donor of tourism. You have China, Japan, South Korea nearby, and have to create favorable conditions for those tourists who would like to come to our country. And this comfort begins with the opportunity for getting entry visas to our country. And if from 2014 we have a visa-free regime with Korea, and as for China, there is a very efficient mode for group tours. And last week there was a meeting in Kazan where we agreed the opportunity to reduce the number of groups from 5 people to 3 people and extend the stay period for visa-free trips from 14 to 21 days. And we believe that this procedure should be applied to other countries like BRICS countries, and to us, of course, India is very promising in terms of tourists that may come to our country, and this is an important part of our work which should be carried out. When we talk about the Far East region, it's pretty obvious that the Far East should become the eastern gate to our country. This is due to the geographical location of the Far Eastern region. And to me, a lot has been done for Vladivostok and Primorye to become the tourist entry hub. But we would also like the Khabarovsk territory and the city of Khabarovsk to play the same role. And the work carried out by our colleagues from the Far East on creating the package-based and intra-regional products. And I like the presentation of Екатерина Ивановна, because it was for the first time this year that Russian travel operators created those intra-regional packages. And to us, the aim for the travel industry is to spread those packages across the entire Russia. And of course, the Far East of Russia should be a priority. Those package-based inter-regional products could be really interesting for people who live in western regions of our country, because sadly, this flow from west into the east is not so big, and we would like it to grow by a number of times. So, but creation and promotion of such products allow us to achieve these goals. Also, we have to work much to increase proposal of our travel products for domestic and foreign travelers. And of course, the Far East of Russia is a unique territory. To me, industrial tourism could be quite promising, because in the Far East we have a lot of unique industrial sites, for instance, production facilities of the aerospace industry, or like diamond producing enterprises like Kimberlite tubes, and we realized that the quality of diamonds is so high that many would like to see the way these diamonds are produced. And of course, we need to extend the opportunities for cultural and informative tourism. And we also have potential for the military and technical tourism. We need to extend types of the tourism, and of course tourism for gourmets has a number of has competitive edge, and we, as residents of the western part of Russia, only find them when we come here. The perfect environmental situation, good fish, good poultry, and all this should be promoted as a product. And so regarding promotion, it's not enough to create a good tourist product, but the product should be actively promoted and sold within and outside the country. So, and dear colleagues, I would like you to know that from 2015, the Federal Agency on Tourism implements as part of a public-private partnership its program Visit Russia, and we created marketing offices in the People's Republic of China, in Germany, in the United Arab Emirates and in Finland, and based on the public-private partnership, we want them to exist in other regions with generate main tourist flows, and we need to fill them with information. We need to explain why it would be exciting for tourists to come to our country. So, dear colleagues, I realize that you have high-quality product you want to promote. So, having this information in hand, please share this information with us, and we will be actively in promoting this project abroad. And also, I believe that cruise tourism by sea and by river has a huge potential. From the south of the Asia-Pacific region, there is a big flow directed northwards, and we need to create conditions for those travelers to visit Russia. And regarding tools we use, together with our colleagues, we take part in the federal special purpose program on developing domestic and foreign tourism. And the Far East is actively involved, but to me, the potential of the Far East is far from being exhausted. And it's quite recently that the regions of the Far East became part of this program, but based on the trends for development tourism in the Russian Federation, I would consider improving finance, because based on current finance volumes, it's not possible to promote all projects in the Far Eastern Federal District. For instance, we have 25 regions of the country involved in the federal special target program, and 13 regions more would like to be involved, but we lack finance. From my side, I would like to express confidence in the fact that development tourism is a priority for the Far Eastern regions, and I'm fully confident that we will make the best use of your potential, and that it will contribute to social and economic development of your regions, and we will do everything necessary to implement this goal, and I would like to wish you
all. Colleagues, I believe that I will have to speak at the same time. So, on our part, we suggest and we address this suggestion to our colleagues, and we will take on this responsibility. We will invite all major travel operators, and we will consider the proposals of package tours like Eastern Ring of Russia, and we will bring it home to the travel operators, and we will do it jointly with you. So let us coordinate our efforts. And our colleague from the Amur region has voiced something that I would also like to articulate. Every region has some unique features for development of tourism. For example, Amur region has space, land, and the whole world has several space launching sites in very few numbers. So every region has to consider what they have, what unique features they can boast with, and we believe that they're obvious and trivial, but they can attract tourists both from Russia and from all over the world, and federal agency on tourism is our ally. So together we will promote this product to offer it to tourists. Thank you, Oleg Petrovich. Thank you, colleagues. Therefore, we finish our session. Thank you.